Well, hello everyone, it's little Rhonda Lee, and thanks for joining me for this edition of my Scrappy Happy Hour. And also, my very first video for Tupelo Designs LLC. So, what I decided to do today, with all the goodies I got in my design team package, I decided to start with the clay. That just seems so fun to me. So, I got the DOS black colored clay and the Martha Stewart's molds here. And you guys, this is a new like video cam setup for me, so excuse me while I get used to this new view. So before we go any further though, you guys better have your beverage ready, okay? And I'm still celebrating and I had some champagne left, so I made myself a mimosa on the rocks, okay? Because I'm not gonna waste that stuff, so cheers you guys. Okay, I'm gonna figure somewhere to put it now. Whoa, okay. I hope I don't geek out and like spill this everywhere. Okay, so yeah, I thought I'd start with the funnest thing in the box. I thought something I really had never tried. So I watched some videos on YouTube and got some little tips. So we're gonna open this up right now. And of course, you can find this this clay in Tupelo Designs store. They have it in quite a few colors, white and black like this, and I think it like a magenta and green and yellow and red possibly. So, okay, might be a little cold in my garage here, I don't know, but it's kind of soft. It's kind of soft. So I've been getting some tips. So. You guys are just gonna watch me discover things as we go here. So let me open the molds here. And these are really cute. I like these. And Tupelo Designs has a lot of different molds too, besides this particular pack. This is the decorative silicone molds. They have different ones. They have like, the Romantic Collection. They have ones with leaves and flowers and butterflies and letters and garden things and all that kind of stuff. So, what I like the best is this one, this like, frame. That's the one I'm really wanting to do a lot of things with. Okay, I'm scared. No. Okay, so they said like work it a little bit, get it a little warm a little bit. And that you don't need very much. So, we should just take out a little bit. Okay. And then, like, I guess you just press it in there. So, here we go. I think I'll start with the frame one. I'm going to do a lot of them. And also, I saw some videos where they use rubber stamps to mold some of it with. And I want to try some of that, too. So... so we'll do it all. Let's see how it goes here. Mm-hmm. It looked really easy. You just like press it in there and spread it around. Get it like as flat as you can and as even as you can. It's very soft, so if you have sore hands and stuff, I think, you know, this will be good. I mean, and I do occasionally get, I don't know if I have arthritis or what it is, but you know. So yeah, this is pretty smooth. Yeah. So and look, you get it a little warm and it really works really good. It spreads really good. That's nice. Alrighty. Exciting. I mean, I hope I can't mess this up. So, the other day, yesterday, was Tupelo's birthday, and Gene had and Mike had a big sale. And I think probably a lot of you guys took advantage of that. Got some good stuff. I think I put too much there. I got some tools here too that I might need in a minute. I think I did this right. You guys are just gonna see me doing it just as I'm learning it. So we'll see how this goes. Now they say it takes 12 to 24 hours to harden. So when we get to that stage after I've done a lot of molds and stuff, then I will pause the video and then come back, I guess, tomorrow after it's hardened, and we'll take it from there with what we're gonna do with it. Okay. I guess that's good. Okay, so they say press it in there. Wait a minute or so. And then because this is a silicone mold, you know, it'll bend and it'll come out really easy. So let's see. Oh, it really does come out easy. If it's Ronda proof, it's definitely foolproof. Oh wow, check it out. That looks pretty good, look. That's not bad. And I like the black because I do a lot of projects with black, and I'm thinking about putting this like on the front of one of my journals that has a lot of black. And what I plan to do, put this aside to dry, is when it's dried, like rub some of this Inca Gold, which you can also find in the store. They have it in all different colors, but I just have the gold right here. And yeah, you know, I'm gonna rub that on after, but I gotta wait till it dries a little. So that's my plan there. And then also I saw some videos where they dusted with a brush some of the Perfect Pearls on it and looked really killer. So I can't wait to try that too. In fact, I might try that on one of these before it dries because I saw someone do that and it worked out good. Apparently you can do anything to it you want. You can use all kinds of inks and paints and everything on it. So that's really great. So okay, that one was a success, yay. Okay, I'm going to fill the rest of these molds, too. And I guess I should put this back. Okay, yeah. They say you should keep this in the Ziploc bag it came in. You know, because it's air dry, so we don't want it to dry out. And another tip I saw was if you want, you know, put a little damp paper towel in it, too, so... I think I'll wait and do that once I'm done for the evening. I'll put that in there too, so it won't dry out. But it does come with its own Ziploc bag, so that's a good idea. All right, so here's the next mold, and it's like these like decorative little embellishments. So I'm gonna do the same thing. Press that in there. Thank God they came out with this kind of stuff because if it would require baking, I probably never would have got around to trying that craft. Uh-oh. Another thing I read about it and stuff is that if you made a mistake or you didn't fill every bit of your mold the way you wanted, you can put it right back in, you know, and get it right. So it's kind of no fault, you know. It's really soft and it feels kind of wet, but it's not, and it's really neat. It seems a lot more pliable than regular clay to me. You know, regular clay is a little stiffer. I'm not going to worry too much about what's like the edge of it looks like, because I know I can trim it after when it's like wet like this, or even when it's dry, you can trim it real easily. So I'm not going to worry about that too much right now. Oh, I thought I'd mention a little something to some of my followers. If you're from Germany, my last video was blocked in Germany, and only Germany. And Germany just has a little more strict laws, so copyright laws. And yeah, they detected, they might again, but they detected that I had some music playing in the background. That I guess was against the law in Germany for me to play or something. So I got blocked. So if anyone from Germany can't view my videos, I'm sorry, and I'll try to you know, keep aware of that. So the way I can get around is they got a new feature now where they'll just delete that part where that part of the music's playing. But it also deletes the rest of the audio, which isn't so great. But anyway, just understand that, you know, it's nothing, not a whole lot I can do about it, but. Okay, there's that one. So. Anyways, tomorrow, some of you guys might know, it's a really exciting event, is, tomorrow's probably going to be, or today, what might have been the last day for Mike from Tupelo Design Store. It will be, tomorrow will be his first day, full time, working in the store. Yay! Yep, I think today was his last day working elsewhere, and he will be able to devote 100% to the store now. Congratulations, Mike. Okay, put that in there. Let's see what happens now. See, I just pressed it in there. I know it takes forever, but all right, here we go. It's really bendable, these molds. Probably hard to see on the black, I'm sorry. I should get a white piece of paper. But they really do great impressions. It's really neat. Okay, let me get a white piece of paper or something here. Well, I don't have one nearby. Hang on. Hang on. Okay, a paper towel. Here we go. It's kind of ragged around the edges, but like I said, I can trim that later. There's that frame. I think this is going to be cool. Okay. Well, I might as well fill them all, you know? Let's try it all out. All right. Craft without fear. That's what Jane says. And so I try to remember that motto. Right. This one seems a little, like, really deep, kind of little filigree things. I'm sorry if my, is the camera shaking? I got my camera up on the table, and it's a card table. So, you know, it's not the firmest thing. And what I plan to do with these when they're done is I have a journal I'm in the middle of working on, and once these are finished, then I'm going to use them to embellish the cover of my journal. Boy, I sure hope it's not shaking a lot. Might be. I've always wanted to try this clay stuff out, and I just think it's really great that it air dries. And I thought, you know, you could even probably, when it's like pliable still like this, like you could stick a, you know, like a flatback pearl or some, you know, some little gem in it too before it sets up. So they also showed like taking something, this is just a marker, and like rolling it to get it in there evenly. I think I'm like putting maybe too much in here. More than I need to, but you know, there's a learning curve there. So I'm gonna use this tool. Maybe that'll help. I don't know. And I got these tools also from Tupelo Designs. Comes with these different little knives and palette things that are very helpful. Something up here. Okay. Now we're ready to pop it out. This one's a little trickier. Isn't really that hard. I think I'm being more careful than I need to be. There we go. Cute. I know these are going to look really hot when I can spread some ink of gold on them or some perfect pearls. Okay, so that's that. And might as well try the stars out. And the store, you know, they have, like I said, all the colors and stuff like that. And they have a lot of molds, different molds that you can use, too. And alphas and all kinds of different, you know, kind of embellishment shapes and things. Numbers, alphas, they have the Mod Podge molds. I think those would probably work to any kind of mold. You can even make your own molds, actually. I saw in the store that they carry stuff to make your own molds, and I think that's what I'm going to be getting next. You know, then you could, like, get, like, say, a piece of jewelry you like a cameo or something, and make a mold of it. And then use the clay in that. So that sounds pretty cool. I think, what is that stuff called? It's I think it's called Amazing Mold Putty Kit or something like that. It's in the store though. You can find it. You can do a search for it or look over in the left menu there. And you can make your own molds. That sounds like fun. You guys know this music? It's Quicksilver Messenger Service. If you're as old as me, you might remember it. I don't want to waste anything. So this company is from, where are they from? Italy. They come from Italy. I have a friend in Italy. Hi, Kat. She's from Italy. There's also a video on Jane's channel showing a little demo of the clay and molds also. Okay, like this one I think is a good example. Like, I'll try to trim this up right now while it's still, you know, kind of wet. So I'm gonna use this. An X-Acto knife would be better, but it's not necessary really. I just got to get my technique down better. There we go. Okay, it's time for a sip. I'm getting parched. Okay, everybody, take a sip. Cheers. Oh, Can't believe that champagne's still bubbling. And it didn't even pop. If it didn't even pop when I opened it, but it's still bubbly. Wow, I think I'm making a mess here. I don't know. Well, that looks messy, but yeah, all that. There you go, look at it. We'll fix it up later. But you can see it's not that hard, really. It's just, you know, got to have a little finesse. Okay. So, see, this one's still... First one, the frame. Oh, it's getting a little harder. I can feel it now. So I don't know if I should try anything on it yet or not. I think I'll go ahead and roll some out and do some of the stamping I wanted to do. See how that goes. All right. Sorry, my mat is black here, and so is my table, so I don't really have much choice. now, what I need to do is get some of those, this nonstick craft mat palette things that they sell in the store. Get a set of three of those for a really good price, and because I don't really have the room to have, like, you know, a big mat. I don't have a big space to work in. So I think those would be just right because they're like about, I think they're about 8 by 12. So here's 12. Be like that, yeah. And there's three in a pack. So, you know, and they're nonstick. You can heat emboss on them. And, you know, so, or if you do have a bigger space, you can go ahead and you can order by the foot in the store. The custom cut ones by the foot, and they are 36 inches wide, you know, and then you order them by the foot, so that's a good deal. If you have a big table, that's the way to go. I'll be working on getting something here pretty soon. So I think I really need a little more than that. I picked out some of my small stamps to stamp on some of this. So, here's my rolling marker. There we go. Okay. Oh yeah, another thing I saw, I have to grab it though, is you can, like, use your stamping block. By the way, I love the Rocka Blocks. Rock. Oh man, they do. I tried one out. I did a little stamping to try, and I love these things. They do the best stamping, and I'll be doing a video on that soon too. So anyway, you can like press it down with one of these, or you know, if you got one of the big ones, like, you know, one of these things, you know, you can use that too. You just want to make sure you leave it thick enough, like, you know, at least like, you know, an eighth of an inch or something, so you're not too thin with it. Okay, so, all right, so I have these different stamps. I've got one that's a, like a tiki guy. You can see that. It's two stamps. One says tiki and one is the tiki. So, I'm going to put it on a Rocka Block. Go. Okay, here we go. Hmm. I'm gonna try that again. I don't know. I'm afraid I didn't do it good enough. Let's try that again. Looks good. Yeah, I think that's gonna be good. Mm-hmm. I know it's gonna be hard for you guys to see because it's black, but shoot my lighting. This camera angle, I can't even really see what I'm doing. But hopefully you can. So I'm gonna let that dry. And then I'll trim. Well, maybe I could trim some off now. That is kind of a lot of extra stuff. So, just so that I don't have to trim a lot later. So did you guys see the video of Tupelo's birthday haul? I thought that was so funny, so cute. Went to the highbrow doggy store and got all his favorite treats and stuff. That was so cute. Wonder if he's eating them all by now. Yeah, he's adorable. One dry too. Okay. All right. Let's see what else. Oh yeah, I have a heart stamp. This one. I don't know if that's too intricate or not, but I'm gonna give it a go. I think that would, you know, make a really great embellishment. Now, there is a tool in the store that looks like it'd really be a good thing for this kind of thing, like instead of this, it's like a big wide tool. I think it's called like a texture and embossing plate by, I think it's by Dreamweaver. They carry those also. And it looks like it's just perfect for this kind of thing. I think I just pressed some glitter in there. My garage is still, everything I own is covered in glitter still from Christmas. Yeah, there's some red glitter in there. Oh. Okay. That's big enough. Yeah. Okay. Let's try it. Press real firm on it. Okay. Okay. It'll be interesting to see what these look like when they're dry, because it's kind of hard to tell. You know what? I don't know about this mat. I'm gonna do that over. I don't like that impression. Again. Mm-hmm. You need to get one of those, you know, those clear plastic rolling pins or whatever they are. Well, we'll just have to see how that one turned out, but let's see what else can we try. Okay, I have this stamping block here. It's like got all these different sides to it, and it looks like deeply etched. I think that the better, the deeper that etched it is, excuse me, the better I'm thinking here. So let's try that. Jane, you made this look so easy. Okay. I think, like, if you get the white kind, you can add different paints, like all different kinds of medium paints, to it to color it. And you just like would, you know, like put some ink in there and fold it and all that. So you can color them, color this stuff too. Having the right tools would probably make things simpler. But I'm working with what I got here. Where there's a will, there's a way. That's beginning. Okay. So let's see. Which pattern should I pick? I'm gonna pick that one. Okay. I think my table and mat's a little wonky. Oh, that looks good. I like that. That came out pretty good. I'm going to cut it down a little. Yeah, I think that's the key. You need a stamp that's, you know, got some deep pattern to it. at least when you're beginning. Okay. Just think you could make some really cool tiles and stuff. Don't stick. See that, but it looks pretty good. So I'm gonna let that one air dry also. Okay, let's see what else. So I have this other wooden stamp. Now I have these other ones I really wanted to try, but I'm thinking they're too fine, maybe. Maybe I should just stick with the real deep ones until I get to know this better. Now, this was something I really kind of wanted to try. I just got this Sizzix die that I ordered, and it's an embosslets. I haven't even used it yet. I have not put it in my Vagabond and did anything with it, but I was wondering if it would work out for this or not. So here's what it is. I don't know if that's gonna work, because it looks like a double-sided thing, huh? I guess I could press it in one side. So let's see, which side should I do? Well, do a little of both. Let's see what happens. So if anyone watching has tried this before, has any tips or comments regarding this that would you think I might not, you know, find, could appreciate, then by all means, leave a comment. Give me some help here. Okay. This side looks more like a deep etch to me. Doesn't come out. I'm gonna just roll it back up, right? Do something else with it. Wish I had one of those things right now. That scraped off the excess thing. Yeah, one thing I just realized is that this isn't going to bend. So this probably isn't going to work. Because how am I going to get it out? Duh! Well, that was silly. Yeah, you guys are probably all laughing by now. Going, yeah, how are you going to get that out? Like that. Ha 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 ha.
It worked.
Success. Okay, I'm gonna let that dry too. But that is something to consider when you're gonna get crazy with trying different things. Is think about that. I guess how are you gonna get it out of your mold? Because these aren't bendable like the Martha Stewart ones. So okay, got to try that. Let's see what else. I still think I want to try this one because it's a deep edged, nice pattern there. That could make a really cool embellishment. Alrighty. This will be the last one I do. And then I'm going to, even though they're not hardened yet, I'm going to try a little bit of Perfect Pearls on. My mom and my best friend's mom used to make Play-Doh for us kids somehow out of flour or something, flour and water and food coloring or something like that. Didn't want to release. Hey, that looks pretty good too. It's kind of pliable, like it's not as fragile as you think, I guess. You can see that. I think I need a little practice, but here we go. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to take one of these little guys that I did. I should probably zoom in a little. And I'm going to do a little Perfect Pearls to it or whatever. Excuse me while I adjust. I'm gonna try dusting this one here. Can you see me? No, you can't. Probably not. Okay. There we go. I think this is going to be awesome, actually. Look at that. I already like it. Oh, awesome. Yeah, this part's more fun than the pushing it in the mold part. Well, that's awesome. I like it. Look, at that. And I guess you can do it before it's dry. Oh, wow. I like that. That is really neat. I am impressed. That's how it turned out. Look at that. I'm going to focus. There you go. I like it. So, you can dust it with the Perfect Curls before it is hardened. I'm not going to try the rubbing ink of gold on it, because I think you got to wait till it's hard to try that, probably. But I know that's going to turn out great. Now I want to try another color of Perfect Pearls. I like that. That turned out great. Success! Yay! Okay, let's try... I'm going to try this color now. And it is called Perfect Bronze. Okay. I can't get the hang of where my camera is with it this way. Okay, I'm going to go up here. And I'm in frame. Yeah, okay. Sorry. I usually have the camera, like, right between my legs in front of me, and I work around it. So this is a totally different angle and everything. And as most of you that follow me know, I don't do tutorials, so bear with me. I'll get it down. There's a little learning curve here. I'm going to take a star right there. Right there. Okay. And let's dust that one and see what happens. I've got too much. Oh. Okay. So I'll trim all that extra stuff up after. But look at it. That is so neat. I like that. Not too bad. Just think, if you get your own molds too, and you... Wow, that'd be awesome. That's not bad. Look at that. I like that effect. That is really neat. Okay. Well, I kind of want to see what something else looks like now. Let's see. What should I do? Maybe I'll try the tiki guy. Okay, let's try that one. Neat. All right. I like it. It really pops when you get that stuff on it, doesn't it? There's the tiki guy. And then just imagine if you mixed more than one color, had it fading into one another. Let's see. I bet that would look really cool too. So anyway, I think you guys get the idea, and This will be really fun to play with. Let's just add a little blue and see what happens. They blend really good too. I can see some really cool, well, the right stamp, you know, like some really cool things you can do. Look at that. That's awesome. I like that. Well, so there you go. There's my first experiment with the DAS, DAS color clay from Italy that you can find in the store, Tupelo Design, and everything you need you can find there too. The perfect pearls, you know, the tools, the molds, and stuff that I don't even have yet that I'm gonna get, but you might want to think about too, like the craft mats and stuff. That would be a big help, instead of paper towels like I'm using here. And they also have all the brushes, you know, everything you need is there, so go check it out. And I will be back, I guess, tomorrow. As soon as this hardens up, I'm gonna be back, and then we're gonna do some more little things to these things that I pressed out and everything, and see how it goes. I'll give you my critique then, and you can tell me what you think then. And until then, thanks for joining me, you guys, and take another sip. Cheers. Thanks a lot, you guys, for joining me. Bye.